The Tibet Development Forum took place in Lhasa from August 12 to 15. An apparently minor incident during the forum illustrates well the problem of constant surveillance which journalists have to face across the world. Raising this issue is all the more important since quite often they are not even aware of it. The Tibet Development Forum is quite similar to Chinese forums on other topics. The Chinese officials explained the past achievements and their plans for the future. The foreign delegates tried to bring in some information about their own experience in this field. The whole thing happens in a constructive atmosphere of mutual respect during the plenary sessions as well as the group discussions. Critics who only listen to the official discourses might call this a meaningless propaganda operation, but they totally miss the point. The real information exchange goes on behind the scenes. During coffee breaks and mealtime, the participants get the really interesting information by direct interaction with each other. Obviously, the 2 days field trip didn't allow anybody to get representative data about the situation on the ground. For those who traveled to Tibet for the first time, it just gave them a first impression, maybe leading to questions which might find an answer in the future. Anyway, the most important role of the forum was to build up contacts between people, some of whom will stay in touch for many years, and set up a long-term collaboration. This doesn't mean that everything went smoothly. The incident, which is the object of the present report, occurred during one of the plenary sessions. Alessandra Spalletta, working for the Italian news agency AGI, has not even realized what happened to her, despite being an experienced journalist and having lived for several years in Beijing. When she took notes on a small notebook, her neighbor oriented his video camera downwards in order to get a glimpse of what he could not easily see with his own eyes. It seems quite obvious that he is working for the Chinese security apparatus. You will notice the watchful eyes of the person on the left, who seems to be his supervisor. The following images show that this was not the only camera directed towards the audience. However, as so often, things are not what they seem to be. Let's have a look at these images again. The lens of the video camera is clearly facing forward. The telelens of my camera compresses the lateral distance between the people, which is actually quite considerable. There is no way he could film her notes in this way. He is no secret agent and he is no supervisor. The cameramen are actually what they seem to be, namely cameramen working for the media. So, where is the surveillance? The only camera which was filming Alessandra's notes was mine. But because of a miscalculation of the zoom factor and the lens distortion, despite state-of-the-art resolution, contrast and sharpness enhancement techniques, I just can't read what she wrote. Maybe you are better at reading her handwriting than I am. If you can read even a few words, please write me an email to the address below. This is vital for national security. Each word Alessandra writes is of great value to everybody who tries to understand the recent evolution of China between tradition and modernity in all its complexity and diversity.